my ghouls, my freaks, my creeps, my devils, my two-faced people. Sarah here, doing a lovely and also creepy quiet Halloween look. If you want to learn how to get this ridiculously ghoulish look, then please keep watching. So the first thing you're going to want to do is cleanse your face with a regular cleanser, it doesn't matter, and then you want to apply a moisturizer so that your face is completely dry free and whatnot. Next thing you're going to want to do is apply a base. This is Max Prep and Prime. So apply that to the face. Now the next thing, because this character is flawless, of course, like any character, you're going to take a foundation, whatever foundation you have, and taking Revlon's Color Stay, and you're going to apply one nice coating of that, because I've got acne and blemishes that I don't want to like appear. Well, this is the time when you're going to choose which side you want the devilish part and which side that you want the pretty part. So you've applied a little generous helping to your face. I'm gonna make this side the cute side and this side the evil side. If you have a white face paint such as this, very cheap, it's $2 from Party City. Take any sort of platform like this. This is my, it's from Mud. It's just a mixing palette. It's very basic. What you're gonna do is take a black one. This is Ben Nye color, cream color stack ups. And you're going to take a little spatula, and you're going to dig some out of here. Enough. Like that. Okay. This is going to be enough for your whole face, and also your neck and chest. And mind you, it's not the entire face, because we're only doing part of it. And now you can use your finger to blend. This in here. You may need to add a little more white because we want it to be more gray rather than like black. But not like tar gray, like that kind of gray. We don't want that gray. We want more of white. So one thing I'm sure you've seen is the glue stick and the eyebrow method. That's what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna do this side, and you're just gonna place the glue stick over the eyebrow, and it won't dry purple, don't worry. But we're going to now tap this, make it tacky, make it so it's like it blends in too. I'm telling you, paper towels, magical. Now if you did see in my one video with Lady Gaga what I did, I took this Ben Nye stack up in cream, well, cream stack up in white, and I went like this, just went in there, and now what you're going to do is begin covering this eyebrow. Now if you do want to stay flesh toned for whatever odd reason that may be, you are going to just apply a concealer over it. So this is just getting a good helping of that stuff on there, and don't go full out yet, because we're going to draw a line. Dividing line. And then take a fresh sponge and dabble over that. Take a very, very, very light nude color. Lip color. This is Max Cream Stick in Summer. Possibly can. Alright, so I'm gonna take that sponge. I'm gonna go with my face paint. Make sure no hair is in the way, like if you're going to be washing it, of course. Oh, and you're nasty. Ew, this is so gross. It feels weird. Ew. Ew, my freaking ear. It's so gross.
Q-tip, and I'm gonna sharpen that. You don't even need makeup remover, honestly. It just like comes off immediately. I'm gonna use this brush, this rounded, I'm just gonna call it a round, it's called Smoky Wide Brush. I guess it's from CVS, Essence of Beauty. I'm gonna go in with my Carbon eyeshadow. Get a good helping of that in there. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna begin drawing a line. And a lot of times you can see how diluted the color on your face is when you do this. So then you wanna go into your cream color and begin putting that over the shadow. I guess the shadow is kind of just like a reminder, hey, I'm here. Then you're gonna begin blending down, start of your contour. So now, to blend it, because we don't wanna take this color off after all the hard work we did. Now we're gonna begin doing is the eyes, because the eyes look much too human. And I'm gonna go over it, over my entire eyelid with a cream, with black. Just the eyelid so far. And underneath.
Friend.
This is Smolder by MAC. You're gonna apply this on your waterline. What we're gonna start doing is applying this black contour to your nose. I'm using the same contouring junk I used before. But you wanna connect this to the crease. Now highlight time.
Yes, we're going to do highlights now.
Take a fresh sponge, that's why I mean have your bag of sponges ready. And we're gonna apply this highlight right above the contour. I'm also going to apply it, let's see, where does light hit me? I'm gonna apply it up here. Right down. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Now you want this highlight to be pretty intense, so pretty intense white. And when you blend it, use the side of your sponge like so. And tap. Because if you like smear and smudge it, not gonna do anything for you. So I'm gonna line my lips with Cherry Liner from MAC. Do that and I'll be right back. So now we have our lip, half of our lip lined. That's so funny. And a red lip color. I'm using Ruby Woo from MAC. And apply this. Okay, there's half of your face almost done. Last thing we're gonna do is take, I'd say, a brush like this guy, and this is from the art store, it's very cheap. And we're gonna take that color, or that the smudgy stuff again. And the reason why we painted over our eyebrow, covered it, is because we're gonna be creating like this really crazy eyebrow. So I'm gonna start, let's see where I wanna start. Probably like a little bit above my eyebrow. And I want it to be really dramatic. But also like, yeah, dramatic and defined. So there's your arch, now go down. This is like chola to the max. So I'm using a little mirror. So this side of the face is done, my darlings. Now, let's move on to the preppy, adorable side. Yay! Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna do for this side of the face, the non-weird looking side, is we're gonna apply a rather, like I wanna say kind of like a heavy powder. And I'm just gonna do this to set that foundation we used earlier. This is
max, mineralized skin finish, natural and light medium. Next thing we're gonna do is take a contouring powder. This is max, blunt. And I create a, okay, so this look, it's like, it's not disgusting like this side, but it's not natural. We're gonna do like really heavy blush and junk, so. Okay, I'm gonna use a liquid liner. This is Urban Decay's liquid liner in Perversion. And I'm gonna make a really pretty, like a sharp cat eye. So I'm gonna probably go like right here. And we want this line on top to be a pretty thick one. So there's your, that's a pretty, I mean, that's a big, big cat eye. That's some girl that's like, I'm so beautiful, I'm gonna do a huge cat eye, girl. So now, what you want to do, darlings, is you want to take a bit of an eyeshadow or something like that matter. What you're going to do is take this colour right here, this lovely colour, and you're going to take an angled brush, and you're going to sweep that on over, more like patching motion, but you're going to do that, yes, you understand. The next thing we're going to do is take a angled brush in that colour again, and we're going to go underneath the eye. That was pretty awesome, right? Come on. Oh, what we're going to do for the outrageous bond, darlings. We're going to take a NARS blush. This is NARS Orgasm Blush. And we're going to take a brush like this. And we're going to start doing is piling this on. And then we're going to take an even brighter blush. This is MAC Pink Swoon. And like I do say in many videos that this color blush is not horrid. I'm gonna take a mix between this NYX color, which is in Narcissus, and Margarita. This is a peachy color, and then this is a really bright Lady Gaga pink color. So I'm not even gonna, well, yeah, I'll outline my lips a little. I'm gonna take this Makeup Forever lip liner in what number is it? 15C. I'm gonna way over outline my lips. Now we're gonna apply this color, which is Narcissus from NYX. So you see what I mean? Bubblegum pink. Then I'm gonna take a dab of this, which is Margarita. To make it a little bit less disgustingly pink. And then I'm gonna take a little dab of this NARS and apply that just right over the lipstick. Hello, I'm really pretty Barbie. This is Espresso from MAC. And I'm gonna apply, I'm gonna really accentuate my eyebrows. I hope that you guys have enjoyed it. And it's a little crazy. It's a little bit like, oh, I really didn't know what to wear today, so I'm gonna wear Zombie and I'm gonna wear pretty something or other, I don't even know. So this was mostly inspired by this play that I am doing the makeup on. It's called Horror High at my school. And my friend Roxanne Conowich is playing a character named Jacqueline Heidi, which also goes along with Jacqueline Hyde, the two-faced freak of the century. I wanted to try this so badly, and I also thought that it'd be a really fun Halloween look, and I'm getting this all over my shirt. This is fun to do, fun as heck to do. It's not that hard to do, honestly. For me, it was pretty cheap, and it was a blast. And so I really hope that you guys enjoy this two-faced look, and if you please check me out on Facebook, facebook.com/SarahGMakeup. Yes. Then I suggest that you go do it now.